Please subscribe down below and check out the streamers in the description or your Minecraft pet will drown.
As slowly as you can imagine, I suppose. I mean,
yeah, whatever.
Well, look, I already loathe both of you, but I'm here to talk, and talk I will. Boys, I am in a war on Twitter.
I've heard.
Yeah, I'm sure you have. There's a company that I will not talk about. I will not name the company, lest they get more free promotion from the big guy himself. They put out a tweet saying that the most liked response to the tweet would end up on a billboard in Times Square.
Oh.
Yeah.
The people love Times Square.
I love Times Square. It's
everyone's going to see this. This is the biggest.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Times Square is the best place on the planet. I love it there. It's honestly like.
It's so charming.
It's like the Mecca of the West, right? Everybody loves going to Times Square. There's nothing bad that happens there. The people there are all fantastic and they leave you alone.
Yeah. They're sweet. They're nice.
They're sweet. They don't say any curse words.
If I'm not mistaken as well, there's one more thing you like, Schlatt.
Yes. So I responded to the tweet quite gracefully. I said, I like men. That's what the tweet that I replied to them with said. And I thought that was funny.
Poetry snaps to that.
How would you guys review that tweet?
Oh, I think that's solid.
It's solid.
Yeah. I would say, you know, poetry at work.
Mm. Yeah. You know? They call me Plato, actually. I think Plato was the first person to have said that.
Was Plato gay?
I'm sure he was. He was Greek. They got
that
up to a whole bunch of stuff.
Yeah, there you go. Right there.
So we've got the Plato of the 21st century going up against Corpse Husband.
Corpse Husband.
Another fellow philosopher.
Yeah. Yeah, the Socrates, you know.
A necrophiliac at heart.
Well.
I don't know if we can say that without catching a suit, perhaps.
His username is Corpse Husband. He's the husband of a corpse.
Oh, I thought the assumption with Corpse Husband is that he is the dead one.
Oh.
Well, yeah. It's a little confusing who's married to who and who's dead.
Who is the corpse?
So clearly he's got to work on his branding a little, guys.
Yeah, he should take a lesson from the Chuckle Sandwich Boys.
The silence was so loud when I made my joke there, too. You guys were like, oh.
Anyways, so Corpse Husband decides to reply to this tweet as well, and he says... you know, he digs through the recesses of his rotting brain to come up with the very hilarious original tweet of "Stream e-girls are ruining my life."
Oh no!
Which is really—it's just self-promotion.
It's just a song that he made. And
it's all about the money with this guy.
It's not about the men, Ted. Which
it's
is what it
about
should
the
be
men
about
with this guy. And listen, guess son how many bitch. Streams. Ted, guess how many streams E-Girls Are Ruining My Life has on Spotify?
How many streams does it have?
100 million! 100 million! It hit 100 million streams today.
There's not even that many E-Girls! There's not even that many of them!
This hedonite wants more! He wants to throw it in the middle of Times Square and get more people to listen to it!
What a little rascal.
Gross. But you know who's got something to say about this?
Me.
Men!
Men. Me and men. That's right.
This is our fight. This is our fight.
Look, I got my Christmas lights still up. Guys, I mean,
you need a present.
I don't have much going for me. Right?
He needs something to elevate him because right now he's on a downward spiral.
I'm on a
he's
downward spiral.
Gaining momentum. Velocity, the physics are all there.
And Corpse Husband is gaining velocity on his tweet.
Because he's
got all his people. He's got Mr. Beast. He's got Dream. He's got Carl Jacobs. He's got Jacksepticeye, Pokimane, Sykuno, whoever else.
Yeah, I
the
call
fuck
some of
Valky
those.
Ray.
It sounds like there's a couple of betrayals in there for you, man.
Carl Jacobs.
I'm angry with him.
Betrayed.
A complete betrayal.
And frankly, it's a shitty grilled cheese, Carl.
I don't understand. And it's funny that you mentioned that.
From what I've heard, it's not Beast at all.
I was actually in the DMs with Carl Jacobs the other day, and I gave him a play-by-play of when I was trying his Carl Jacobs grilled cheese, the Carl grilled cheese, as they call it. And you know, I'll be real honest with you, as I wasn't honest with Carl. All right, I gave him two thumbs up, but you know, for the viewers out there, for our audio listeners, love you to death. Double thumbs down, and you know why?
Ooh.
Because it was cold on arrival, just like the cold symbol that Carl Jacobs has given to our boy Jschlatt on this day of our Lord.
I really didn't deserve it. I really didn't deserve it, you know?
So it's kind of weird to all you men out there. Is this not offensive?
As a man, I'm offended.
I mean, I'm a man, and you know, Schlatt likes him. Carl's taking corpses' side.
You know, as far as I know, yeah.
This is unbelievable. Me too. Guys.
The fact of the matter is, I've put in all the effort I can to try and keep this victory going. I mean, we had surpassed Corpse's tweet in likes multiple times.
For a bit.
After I uploaded to my clip channel, Big Guy just talking about it, begging for likes from anybody I could have.
Yeah.
It's just too much. There's currently three Corpse related hashtags trending on Twitter right now. Hashtag
how
corpse.
How many Schlatt hashtags? How many Schlatt hashtags?
Zero.
No, dude.
Hashtag corpse billboard.
This is as backwards as the hamburger buns on Carl's grilled cheese, dude.
God
That's
damn.
What I got to say about this.
Screw that guy.
Ooh.
Look, hashtag corpse billboard is trending. Hashtag proud of corpse and gasp. Because, you know, his song hit 100 million fucking plays. And hashtag e-girls 100M. Three of them. Three different corpse hashtags. And you know what? I'm losing by tens of thousands of tweets now. And I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do anymore.
Close at one point. Well, remember what happened on Twitter a couple months ago. Corpse, I'm pretty sure, managed to beat the K-pop community in Mr. Beast's challenge.
He's got some firepower behind him. He's pulling out all the stops. And honestly,
where did all these people come from, man? What does he do? I don't know what he does.
What Corpse's husband does?
What does he do?
He sings, man. He sings. He's got a deep voice.
Here's the thing. I'm going to put this out there because he's a musician and he's pretty popular. But I think if something as you know, excuse us if this offends you, Schlatt, in something as trivial as a billboard competition for a random company of which we shall not be named, can you imagine? Can you imagine if someone like Ariana Grande got involved in this? They would blow Corpse out of the water.
It's true.
Their fan base would absolutely obliterate Schlatt.
Schlatt, I got a sudden idea on who you need to get to like your tweet.
Sure. Who?
Ariana Grande.
It's Ariana Grande, believe it or not.
We gotta go to the Grande herself.
You think Ariana Grande supports men?
We gotta stop thinking. We gotta stop thinking Pequeño and start thinking Grande, boys.
Baba Booey.
Baba Booey, dude. Baba Booey.
I think that Ariana Grande has been looking for a while to say thank you next to Corpse.
And also other songs.
Would you be willing right now, Schlatt, to tweet out to Ariana Grande and say, Ariana Grande, God is a woman, but the men need this one, please?
Well, look, Ted, I would, but I have already kind of expended. I've expended all I could
do
at this point.
It would be a platinum tweet.
I already tweeted at Barack Obama saying I need a favor. And you know what he did?
But you haven't tweeted
me.
You haven't tweeted at Ariana, though.
It's just going to be sad if he keeps doing this, man.
It would be sad.
It's going to stop being a war.
Broadcasting my L's.
He's just going to be clawing at everything. He's going to be clawing around like a madman.
You got to give the Grande a chance here, okay?
No, I can't. I won't
be able
to.
She's too Grande. She's too Grande.
What about Nicki Minaj?
That's even bigger. She's bigger.
Is that
true?
They call
her fans the Barbs. That's what I've seen online. They're called Barbs.
Like,
I don't know what it means.
Wire?
I was thinking along the lines more of like Barbies, maybe.
Oh, I was thinking like the, you know, the wire that they put on top of fences.
That like cuts you up if you climb over it.
That really slices you.
Yeah, when
into
I
you?
was If I was Nicki Minaj, I'd definitely be like, yeah, I want to call my fans a bunch of razor wire.
When I get in concert, they all get in formation and put their hands up and sort of like claw their hands so no one can climb over the wall.
They're like X-Men mutants, and they've developed the ability when they like squeeze their butt cheeks and they can just let razor wire come out of their skin and roll around.
That's fucking terrifying.
It's good imagery though for our audio listeners out there. We love you.
Well, hey, look. 3 corpse trends on Twitter. He's got the Jacksepticeye endorsement. He's got the Mr. Beast endorsement. He's got the Dream endorsement. There's nothing I can do at this point. I'm not going to keep. I'm not going to keep begging for likes from everybody I know. This is my thinking on it. This is my thinking. Yep. And I mean, this is top secret, so let's not tell anybody this yet. But, fellas, what if I crowdfund my own poster?
I was actually going to suggest you drop a single.
I mean, think of it this way. I'm trying to do the smallest amount of work possible, right? I'm not trying to sing. I'm not trying to like get
right.
I don't know how much it costs to put, you know.
Okay.
I just did the research
for you right now.
Okay. Well, tell me.
It depends on many factors, including the particular media format you choose, billboard or street furniture, the length of the program, and the share of voice. A billboard can range from $5,000 for a one-day program to well over $50,000. Mm. I'm thinking that if you aim somewhere in the middle, maybe $25,000, just to get you doing, like...
You think I could do it?
I think that it's possible. I think that... This is a pretty good idea, and let me tell you, additionally, and I'm being completely honest with you, I've never lied to you, Schlatt, you know that.
I know you've never lied to me.
I think that would be a banging commentary video afterwards.
Well, hey, this is what I'm thinking. I upload a video talking about how sad I am that Corpse beat me. I'm not sad. Mm. I don't give a shit.
I don't even know what's real, all right?
And I say, right. And in this video, I say, please... Help me fund my own billboard because I am sad, and also I love you.
Mm.
That's okay. Yeah, you're in.
I relaunch the same shirt I launch every month and make thousands of dollars on. Mm. And I say, you know what? I'm going to take the funds from this, but only like 50% of the funds and pocket the other half. And I'm going to put it towards my own billboard. And we're going to get the recognition men deserve.
You're saying it like it's such a noble cause too,
at the same time there's a hint of evil in his cadence
I'm a good guy, Ted. I've never done anything wrong
okay
in my
yeah
life.
Dad, now I hear it Ted. Okay. Definitely.
Yeah, we're definitely.
It's coming out about? A little it's kind of coming
evil?
To the front.
I can hear the Grinch smile that's slowly working up past
his
eyeballs.
Yeah, it's like curling around a couple times as well.
No, I'm not smiling right now.
Schlatt, every word you breathe, I hear the beating of your black shriveled heart, man.
I don't have a black shriveled heart. I'm not a smoker. I've never had smoke in my lungs at all.
It's like a prune. It's like a raisin.
I'm not a raisin.
It's like a throbbing. It's like there's a throbbing raisin in your heart.
Throbbing now? I can show you something throbbing right now.
No.
Boys, please. Boys, please. Bring it together. We're all friends here.
Christ. All right.
Come on, boys. Bring it together.